Oh, hello, Tippy. Did you find Leavenworth?
He's on his way over here now.
Fine. Well, what are you doing back here? Uh-huh, you've been drinking.
So have you.
Well, I handle it better than you do.
Want to know what I think?
I haven't asked you, have I?
You did before. I think if we lost our jobs, we'd feel like a couple of disinfected heels.
Well, maybe you're right about that.
Mr. Scott, what are you letting them do to you? You really want to present fine, intelligent programs, and you're not doing it because you've let this racket seduce you with a lot of money.
Now, listen, kid, I want to tell you something. I've been around long enough to know that you can't eat ideals. You think this sin drama's a pretty filthy mess, don't you?
I think it's contemptible. That woman's been punished enough. She was perfectly justified in doing what she did. And you've got to dig up the whole rotten stew, sneaking around with morals and warnings to young girls. Can't you see what this might do to a family? Well, you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
I've worked for Reynolds too long to be ashamed of myself. There's only one thing I'm interested in, and I don't care how I get it. All I want out of this business is enough money so that I don't have to worry about old age pensions and things like that.
Now, you won't have to worry.
Now, listen, kid. I've been taking care of myself for a long, long time, so I don't need any help from you. Now, you just run along home and sleep it off. The next time I want any spiritual advice, I'll take it from this gentleman here.
You want to see me, Mr. Scott?
Yes, I want to see you. I want to wring your neck. Next time I send you out to write continuity, I want you to write it and not go horsing around in strange places.
Now, if you'll just listen to me a minute, Mr. Scott, I think I've found something very interesting.
Well, what's your alibi this time?
Righteousness has led me to a situation which, in the name of humanity, must be corrected.
Ha-ha, that's a hot one. You talking about righteousness and humanity.
I have met Gloria Pembroke personally.
Well, so what?
Gloria Pembroke's daughter is being married today.
Now, where does that fit in?
Don't you see, sir, this woman of sin, this murderess, is marrying her daughter to an unsuspecting boy. This is something that will revolt the entire world. I was shocked, Mr. Scott, shocked.
Achoo! Just a cold.
But, sir, this girl is as bad as her mother. We are the voice of the people. It is our responsibility.
Who's the man she's marrying?
Malcolm Sims. His father is a big steel man.
Sims, eh? That's interesting. Sounds like history repeating itself. Hey, but wait a minute. What about this Sims family? We're liable to get plastered with a lawsuit.
I might also add, Mr. Scott, we are doing Mr. Sims a great favor.
Oh, we are, eh? Will you do yourself a great favor and get out of here before you miss that broadcast?
Quite right. I mustn't disappoint my public.
Yeah, give him your personal benediction, you big
fat. Shut up. And will you do me a great favor and go home?
It's a pleasure.